Good evening. Keene Church and Keene Worship Choir want to welcome everybody tonight to open the Sabbath with some beautiful Christmas music and performance. And we are also wanting to remind you that we'll be closing the Sabbath as well with more beautiful music and the rest. And so let's begin by invoking God's Spirit. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you have promised that we will not be alone. And you've promised that by giving us the gift of Jesus to be our Savior. Tonight we celebrate the giving of that gift to us, and we ask that your Spirit will be here to guide, direct, lead, and to inspire each of us to greater trust, submission, and love in the face of the act of love that you showed us in Bethlehem. We thank you for all this, and we ask for your Spirit in Jesus' name. Amen.
I think it's the real mother of the baby, the actual baby. Yeah, makes sense.
Imagine the night the Christ was born. From the first holy night on a hillside outside of Bethlehem, when a multitude of heavenly hosts proclaimed Christ's birth to a small group of lowly shepherds, until this very night, some many years ago, the heavens and earth resounded with songs of praise and adoration to God and his remarkable gift. Tonight, we remember him as a tiny baby, yet a king, the Son of God. Oh, holy night and peace on earth.
Glory to God in the highest. by the light that is there to guide us. Jesus will come.
Every story has a beginning. This story didn't begin in that stable in Bethlehem, not when Mary considered these things in her heart, not when the child in Mary's womb was the word that was made the worlds. He was the God who spoke, and the universe was. He was the beginning. From David to Babylon, and almost 14 generations from Babylon captivity to the Savior's birth. We are almost there.
Thank you.
Joseph and Mary, the scandalous match made in heaven that Providence brought together to fulfill their parts on the stage of redemption. Were they afraid? Did they doubt? Consider Mary, a young Jewish girl with child, on a grueling 80-mile road to Bethlehem. For her, it was one step at a time as she carried the child who made the sun, moon, and the stars, and the very world her son would one day die to save. And can you hear Joseph tenderly whisper to his new bride, "Hold on a few more miles. You're almost there." Joseph, a carpenter, an honest and faithful man who did the right thing at the right time. But it must have been confusing. Then he looked at her.
She looks like an angel that I saw. I believed that God had chosen me. I felt the hand of heaven move me, and Mary has my heart. Father, help me do my part.
Bethlehem, which art little to be among the thousands of Judah, out of thee shall one come forth.
I know we have traveled far, see it on your face. I'll find you a resting place. Tell me, can you see the light? Mary, don't give up. God has not forsaken us.
There is an inn in Bethlehem. You can rest your head, there's a room for him. The angel did say, don't be afraid. Even though it's dark, we will find. Do you think
The child is born, the Word made flesh, who stepped out of everywhere into a little somewhere, a significant somewhere, into a virgin's womb, into a stable in Bethlehem to save the poor fallen world that he so loved. He is the comfort in your suffering. He is the end of your misery. He is the sleep that gives because he loves you. He is the rest after your hard work, God with us. He is eternity's sonnet. He's heaven's hallelujah. Is the shout of the glorified, the song of the redeemed, the chorus of angels, is the everlasting oratorio of the great orchestra of the sky. We worship you, Emmanuel, all divine. In you, our Father's glories shine. The wandering in the wilderness, the waiting, the weeping, the longing was over. They were there, angels, shepherds, and the baby in a manger. It was like a Christ-like wonder of salvation. You are not alone. God is with you. He's with you in your loss. He's with you in your doubt. He will be with you in your joy. He stepped out of his everywhere into your somewhere. He is the quiet voice calling you, don't be afraid, just listen. From the beginning, before the foundations of the earth, God knew your name. The child was born for you.
Oh,
Emmanuel, God with us, the creator of all things, becomes a creature, a child. He is closer than your heartbeat, Prince of Peace, Mighty God, Emmanuel.
Lord of life, Lord of all, He is the Prince of Peace, Mighty God, Holy One, Emmanuel, 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 Emmanuel. Thank you.
The Word was in the beginning. God spoke into the void. The darkness obeyed, and the light gave life to all the living. In the beginning, in our perfect paradise, man fell. It could all have ended that day, but God gave a promise, a salvation promise. It's the greatest story ever told. Like any good story, this one, God's story, calls us to respond. We can cast it aside as just a fable, or we can bow in reverent worship. We can label it irrelevant, or we can give our very lives to embrace it. No matter our response, we simply can't ignore it. The only question? What will we do with this, the truth of God's story? The wise men who saw the star came and adored him. Oh, come all ye faithful, let us adore him.
Oh,
hear them chime in this place. It's that time of year. Church bells are ringing. Do you hear what I hear? Everywhere, holy night, you see, so you believe. Come join heaven's choir. Jesu joy, a man's desire.
Glory to God in the highest. Hosanna, our Lord is with us.
Never stop searching by the light that is there to
frankincense and myrrh. As a kid, I used to think that was not very practical. Baby Jesus would appreciate it more, a rattle, or perhaps a teddy bear, your supply of Gerbers, your supply of diapers, gold and frankincense and myrrh. But God knew what to impress upon the wise men, because Joseph would be leaving his income there at the carpenter shop. He would be going on a journey that would be expensive. No guaranteed job over there in Egypt. God knew what he was doing, because gold and frankincense and myrrh were very practical gifts.
We came tonight not to worship the choir, but to worship with the choir. And I hope you brought gifts for the choir. Now let's see. Careful. Let's see. Did you bring?
It is.
Oh, okay. Did you bring myrrh? I don't know what it looked like, but it was probably in a pretty container. And they make perfume out of it. But the choir smells really good, so they don't really probably need any perfume. Well, did you bring, frankincense. They could use that in the choir room, maybe. Maybe it needs a little smelling good. Did you bring frankincense? Maybe not. Or did you bring gold? Or did you bring the modern equivalent? Well, let's see if I can get it out here. The modern equivalent of gold? I bet you did. And if you did, and if you give it, we can continue to help the choir sing and tell the story of Jesus, who we did come to worship tonight.
Let's pray. Gracious Father in heaven, we're so thankful for your generosity in giving your only son. We're thankful for the choir's generosity in giving countless hours in practice and preparation for this program. Lord, help us all to be generous tonight in giving. In Jesus' name, amen.
Birth of Christ, and we want to thank Sister Juanita Browder, and we want to thank the choir, we want to thank the actors that portrayed so well, our narrator, and our thoughts have been taken back to that night over 2,000 years ago, and hopefully this Christmas season we will have a place in our hearts for our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Would you bow your heads with me for the benediction? Gracious Father in heaven, we want to thank you from the bottom of our hearts for your great gift of love in your Son, Jesus Christ. Thank you because during this Christmas season, we can reflect upon the great debt that we owe you. And we trust that through the portrayal of your birth this evening, that we have witnessed and heard the songs of praise, that we may have been drawn closer to you this evening, that your presence may fill our hearts and our minds, that we may never forget that great gift that you gave so many years ago, but is so relevant today still. Thank you for each one that's here tonight, the families that are represented. We ask your blessing upon the choir and those that had a participation tonight, that they may continue to uplift your name and bring the story of salvation to our hearts and to many others. Thank you, Lord. And as we leave this place, may your presence go with us. And we pray this in Jesus' precious name. Amen.